I think it's really important to distinguish between blockchain and cryptocurrency. Basically, a blockchain is one implementation of a distributed ledger.
Bitcoin is digital money, so a transaction is just sending from Alice to Bob.
Cryptocurrencies use blockchains to store their transactions.
Ranging in between $250 billion and up to $750 billion in total assets across the space. You also probably know that this financial asset has been used on dark markets. But contrary to what you might read in the press, on any given day, the market share of this activity has in fact been dramatically falling.
There was this really big peak in January, and that was actually an interesting situation that happened. There was a game called Crypto Kitties. It accounted for 13% of all transaction fees that were on the network. The network really slowed down, people weren't using it. It kind of really just showed people that there needed to be a lot more scaling solutions on Ethereum.
And you can actually use a blockchain ledger to store many things that aren't cryptocurrency transactions.
I think one thing that I'm paying particular attention to is identity management and reputation services.
This was really a way for us to think through how do we solve identity management problems differently using blockchain.
So someone moved to the US from a different country, they don't really have as much of a credit history in the US, even though despite they might have had a great credit history in their own country. And so as you move to all these different places and you use all these different financial services, this reputation doesn't carry with you.
So our vision really is to have one shared identity across the three different touch points in your health episode of care. We start with having what we call a portable ID that's stored in the blockchain. There are definitely applications for this kind of a portable ID concept across other sectors as well.
With open blockchain transactions, these types of currency transactions, you need more information to contextualize individual transactions to understand what they constitute.
If you have an encrypted blockchain, then you can obfuscate all of the transactions that are happening. And so anyone who views the blockchain doesn't actually learn anything about the data that is being sent.
Like, you can verify that things happened, but to gain greater context about how they connect to the real world or how traceable are these different things, you need a lot of expertise.
You all work in various industries. I highly recommend thinking about how smart contract logic can really help make your industry more efficient.